Chef's Table is a Netflix documentary series, season one of which premiered on Netflix on April 26, 2015. Show creator David Gelb has produced a piece of art which transcends what it means to be a documentary series. I watched Chef's Table late at night when the third season had just come out. I had nothing better to do, and quite frankly, it was one of the best decisions of my life. Within the first two episodes, I knew I'd discovered my favorite TV show of all time. That is not an understatement. Hi, my name's Arkan Paul, and I'm starting this series to dissect one of the best TV shows available to our species right now. It is a masterful combination of all aspects of filmmaking, and there's just not enough analysis of it online. I'm hoping to fill that niche as Volume 5 of Chef's Table is coming out this September. I can't recommend this show enough, and I suppose we need to start from the top. Let's begin by dissecting the intro to Chef's Table. Each season, however, has a change in the visuals, so I'm going to pick my favorite. Season 2. Welcome back. I'm hoping you enjoyed that. So why, in my opinion, is this intro so damn powerful? At its core, it's simply introducing the show, right? Yet the visuals combined with the accompanying music blend together to create something utterly jaw-dropping. This intro is magical, as it's doing two things at once. A, letting you fall in love with the visual feast presented before you, and B, introducing you to all the chefs that will be involved in the season. The English language doesn't contain enough praises to highlight the musical ecstasy that is Winter Wonderland by Vivaldi, recomposed by Max Richter. I'm going to purely focus on the editing of this intro and manage the other aspects of filmmaking in later episodes. There are, in my belief, three key components to the editing of this intro that help it stand above its peers. Exhibit A, the story. The intro is broken into five specific sequences. One, the setup. All of these shots show the restaurant opening, setting up, the tables are being set, the flames are bursting into life. This stays for about 17 seconds. 2. Introduction to the chefs. This tells the audience of all the different people we're going to meet this season, and it stays for about 6 seconds. 3. The food. Well, this is pretty self-explanatory, it's literally just food porn, and I don't think anyone is complaining, it is gorgeous. 4. The dinner rush. This matches one of the faster moments in the song, and it represents the restaurant at the height of its hours, when the dinner rush is real. This stays for about 11 seconds. And 5, let the episode begin. The editing slows down, the pace comes better, and the shots provide a sense of satisfaction, which allows the show to begin very positively. The show's intro is a perfect minute, and the segments follow the chronology of a night in a restaurant. The story is presented before us. It's almost as if we are going to dine in these restaurants from the beginning to the middle and ultimately the end. It's very poignant. We enjoy it. Exhibit B. This is smaller and works on a more subconscious level and was brought into the spotlight in 2017's Baby Driver. The film geeks already know what I'm talking about. Each edit is synchronized to the music. You would be hard-pressed to find a single cut which does not match a beat in the song, Winter Wonderland. It's a small thing, yet the significance and professionalism it adds to anyone's work is monumental. There is something very aesthetically pleasing when all the cuts match moments or the beat in the song. It creates a flow in the edit, and every second is pleasing. You engage with the show without needing an extra push. all because the edits matched the music. Exhibit C, the actual footage that is used. Now, the Symphony of Winter 1 has a variety of slow, medium, and fast-paced sequences within the song. Thus, to match, the editors very cleverly utilized the same principles, embracing a variety of shots, including slow motion, normal speed, and time lapses. Each add weight and poignancy to the visuals, amplifying the wonder presented before you. You feel the magnificence, you don't just admire it, you become personally involved with these shots. Film is an audiovisual experience, thus a perfect combination is just that much more satisfying. If you have moments that don't match, you get something that's clunky and a bit off. These key lessons should be something we indie filmmakers should definitely incorporate into our own films, to help express our own stories with greater clarity. I hope you enjoyed this video. Next week, I'll cover composition in Chef's Table, and I'll use this episode regarding Gagan Anand as my example. So, give it a watch. You won't regret it.